Good morning, amigos. So, Saturday. You know what that means? It means we're going to screw around with this motor and not get anything accomplished. That's right. All right, so we need to get the water pump put on. So, a gasket, we got to get the water pump put on. Need to put some anti-seize on these, get the other ones installed. What else do we need to do to it? Get the pan on, get the oil pump, put the oil pump on, put the pan on. Make sure we got the flex plate and the block plate that goes between the two of them so the converter lines up correctly. And then I think it's about ready to go in. So then we'll need to move the car. It's over there. That's going to involve hooking a chain to it and just dragging it over here, because I ain't pushing that heavy son of a bitch. It's heavy and it's got a spool in the rear end, so that means as soon as you try to turn, it wants to stop. We'll need to get our plywood moved so we've got somewhere to work on it. We come on over here. We bought a shop light to put up in there. We've got one shop light, and then we've got some of the— here, I'll show you. And I've just got those. Oh, I need to turn that down a little. I've got those. We've got, as you can see, there's four of them. But the problem is, and that shop light down there is crap. I think only one side works. I put new bulbs in it and still only one side works. So I just need to replace it. The problem with these, with the old incandescent bulbs in them, is those bulbs burn out. Those bulbs burn out faster than our president's brain cells die. So I figured, you know, we'll just buy us a shop light, a new shop light with the LED bulbs, with the, you know, an Amazon purchase. We'll give that a shot. We'll hang that up. I only bought one for now. If I put that up and I decide I like it, I'll buy another one. If I decide I don't like that style, I'll buy something else to put on the other end. But we need to put something on this end because it's dark. Anyway, let's get to working on this thing so we can make some progress. It's almost the end of July. It's the last weekend in July. And I'm not gonna lie, I had really hoped this thing would be running by now. But, you know, stuff had other plans, so. Let's see if we can at least get it set in the car this weekend. That would be good progress. Anyway, that's enough babbling. Let's get to work. So this is cool. So when I ordered these, it said it was a package of four. But when the box showed up, I mean, you know, look at it. It looked like it was one. And I thought, well, advertisers aren't always exactly known to be truthful. But you look, there's actually four in there. So that's cool. So we'll get at least two of them put up in there, maybe three, depending on how bright they are. And then I might even hang one of them out here. Just because. I mean, I learned that self-tappers will drill right into that stuff fairly easily, into the beams. And I could just hang one right here. Well, I could hang it, you know, here. Well, maybe there, from there to there. And it would put a little light in this area once I ran a drop cord, because as you can see, there's no power run out here anywhere. All right, back to work. Oh, I did get the gasket on there. It's not real pretty, so ignore that. All right, we got a little anti-seize on there. My bottle of anti-seize is about 4 4. It's really old. I'm surprised it's so freaking works actually. Thank you. Water pump's on. Water pump's on. I've got anti-seize on all the bolts and all those. And the more I look at these, the more I think I need to pull them out and paint them. Probably do them one at a time, one or two at a time. But oil pump is on. We need to flip it over and put the pan on. Progress has been made. Water pump, oil pan with oil pump pickup tube. Got anti-seize on those, and now it's brake time. So all you small block Ford people, you recognize this. This is the one that goes from the thermostat housing down to the water pump. So we take our old water neck, the factory one, and it fits. Well, as you can see, it clearly fits tight on there because I can't even do it one-handed. I can't make it. I can make it go barely. So now we get over here to this aftermarket one, and that's no bueno. Yeah, that's no good. So it's the same size on that end as it is here. So we need to find a 90-degree 5/8 hose. Otherwise, we gotta change thermostat housings. Bummer. All right, so at this point, that's probably about all we're gonna do on this today. It basically needs to come off of the engine stand and get the flex plate put on it, the block plate and the flex plate. We did find a hose on Amazon that will fit this. It's 5/8 on both sides, so we ordered that. It'll probably be too long. We'll need to cut it to make it fit, but it was $8. Yeah, whatever. I don't even know what it's for. I think it was an AC Delco thing or something or another, whatever. But it's 5/8 on both ends, so it'll fit. Once we get it in the car, we'll get the fuel pump put on it. We'll get the pulleys put on and the brackets up front, but I don't want any of that crap hanging off the front of it while I'm trying to wrestle it into the car. There's less stuff hanging out here in the way. You know, because I'm not taking the hood off. So this will be done for the day. Now we need to get that stuff picked up and get us a spot to actually work on it. Get the car drug over here, probably tomorrow. And then the real fun begins. Yeah, it's all right. It's not that hard to put in. Anyway, so that'll do it for today. Better. What the hell was that? Well, it's not supposed to rain tonight, so we got a little more ambitious than we intended. So there's where we're gonna put the motor in. We moved it from over there all the way across here to there. It involved that piece of plywood and that piece of plywood. Run it to that one. Put that one in front of it, pick that one up, put it in front of it, pick the other one up, put it in front of it, you know, all the way to over here. So anyway, so we'll get the car moved over here tomorrow. It's not supposed to rain tonight. It's not supposed to rain tomorrow. But that being said, it's supposed to rain Monday. So that means we will have to get it put in the car tomorrow, period. Anyway, that's gonna do it. Thanks for watching.